Unit 1 introduces a lot of new list methods that you may never have seen. So let's talk about count, sort, and reverse. So list.count of x returns the number of occurrences of x in the list, and here we've just called it list. The way you would use this is you would write the name of your list here and whatever element you want to count. I should mention that I've basically taken this description straight from the Python documentation. List.sort sorts the list in place, and I'll talk a little bit more about what in place means later. And list.reverse does what you would think. It just reverses the elements of the list, and again, it does so in place. Now, let's try using these methods. Let's define a list of the Udacity professors. In this list, I've included all of the professors of the 6 classes, and you'll see that Dave's name comes up twice. This is because Dave teaches 2 of the classes. Also, it makes this problem a bit more interesting. Let's say we want to know how many times Steve's name shows up on this list. For this example, it's pretty easy to count ourselves, but let's have Python do it anyways. We'll define a variable called SteveCount and set it equal to this. Here, the name of our list, dot count, and I'm counting the occurrences of Steve. If I print SteveCount, I get 1, just as I'd expect. We could also count the number of occurrences of Dave, and when I run this, I get 2, as expected, Dave and Dave. Okay, now let's see what happens when we sort this list. We'll define a new variable called sortedProfs and set it equal to udacityProfs.sort. When I print sortedProfs, I get none. Wait, what happened here? I would have expected a sorted version of this list. And this is where that in place comes from that I was talking about before. Methods that work in place only modify the existing list. They modify Udacity profs. They do not create a new list. In fact, since we've just sorted Udacity profs, let's see what happens when we print Udacity profs. And now you can see that they've been sorted in alphabetical order. Isn't mutability just wonderful? Now, poor Wes is always at the end of these sorted lists. Let's give Wes some love by reversing this list. And just as we'd expect, this is the same list, but sorted in reverse alphabetical order. There's plenty other Python list methods, and feel free to check out the link below this video to see them.